Welcome back, kids. Today we are going to learn lesson number 2, Shyam's Horse Cart from First Standard English Bal Bharati. Lesson number 2, Shyam's Horse Cart. Look, listen and read aloud. Shyam started in his horse cart to go to the fair. On the way, Madhu and Meera said, "Can we come?" "Oh, yes," said Shyam. You know, kids, what happened? There was a fair in the Shyam's village. So he decided to go and visit fair on his horse cart. So he gets started his horse cart, and on the way he meet Madhu and Meera. So Madhu and Meera asks him, "Can we come to see the fair?" So the Shyam said, "Yes, yes, you can come." So what were a place in his horse cart? The dog saw them. He asked, "Can I come?" "Oh, yes," said Shyam. Then they meet a dog there. And even this dog asks Shyam, "Can I come with you? Even I want to see the fair." So Shyam said, "Oh, yes, you can come with us." They were going through the fields. The peacock saw them and asked, "Can I come to the fair?" "Oh, yes," said Shyam. Then on the way they meet peacock. They are going through the fields, and in that field or the jungle he meet this peacock, and this peacock even asks, "Where are you going? If you are going to visit the fair, can I come with you to see it?" "Yes," said Shyam. And all these guys, all these children and this dog said, "Yes, yes, you can come with us," and they give a place to sit peacock here. When they were crossing the river, the frog asked, "Can I come to the fair?" "Oh, yes," said all of them. Shyam said, "Come and sit near me." Now what happened, kids? When they crossing the river, they met a frog. And you know, na, the where's the frog's house? Yes, frog lived in the water or river. So on the way, they meet this frog, and even this frog asks him, that "Can I come to the fair with you?" And see, kids, there's no place for sitting this frog. So Shyam said, "Oh, you can come with us, but sit near me." So even this frog sit in the horse cart. They saw the fair from a distance. The peacock was so happy. It spread its feathers and started dancing. But one feather touched the dog's ear. He sprang up and barked loudly. And you know, kids, what happened? When they come near to fair and they saw it from a distance, the peacock was very happy now. And you know what peacock does when they are very happy? When it was raining, what they do? Yes, they open their feather or they spread their feathers and start dancing, na? Even here, if this peacock, it spread its feathers and started dancing. And after spreading its feather, this feather touches dog's ear. And like this, it touches the dog's ear, and dog was very afraid and he started barking loudly and he sprang up. He became very mad, "Who touches my ear?" And he started barking. And then what happened, you know? Madhu was frightened. Meera fell on the frog. The frog fell on the horse, and the horse was so frightened that he ran helter-skelter. And then you know what happened, kids? When peacock spread its feathers, this feather touches dog's ear and dog's barking loudly. And after dog's barking, this Madhu was very frightened. She was afraid of dog and she fell on Meera. And this Meera, she fell on the frog. And this frog falls on a horse. And now horse is very frightened. "Who fall on me?" And then he start running helter skelter. He start running here and there, and all of them were fall down. Shyam fell off. The Madhu and Meera also fell off. One by one, all of them fell off. Like that, kids. One by one, Madhu, Meera, Shyam, dog, this peacock, frog, and even the horse. They all running, this horse is running helter skelter, and this all fall down. The horse kept running and stopped when it reached near the fair. And this horse, he was very frightened, he was very afraid, and he kept running on running, and he stopped when he reached near the fair. Shyam, Madhu, Meera, the dog, the peacock and the frog were all panting when they reached. Till then, the horse became quiet and relaxed. In the evening, they returned happily in the horse cart. And then what happened, kids? When this horse, when all of this, Shyam, Madhu, Meera, dog, peacock and frog, they were fall down, this horse kept on running. So, they need to walk till they reaches fair. And they are now, they all become very tired now. They are panting now. Panting means they have become very tired now when they reach to the fair. But when they reach to the fair, they become very happy. They visit the fair. They sit on this wheel and merry-go-round. They visited this hut. They buy some balloons there. Yes, and they all are become very happy now. And till this time, the horse become very quiet and relaxed. And now this horse is not anymore afraid or not more frightened. So in the evening, they sit in this horse cart and return home happily. Now kids, we are going to learn the difference between one and many. Now listen, tell and write. Kids, when we are going to talk about one thing, we call it as a one bird. Or when we are talking about more than one bird, we are call them as a many birds. So one bird, many birds. Now repeat after me. One dog, many dogs. One peacock, many peacocks. One horse, many horses. One field, many fields. One feather, many feathers. One river, many rivers. One thing, many things. One banana, many bananas. One frog, many frogs. One room, many rooms. In all these examples, we understood when we put S after the word, it becomes a plural form. Or when we are talking about the singular or the one thing, we does not put here S. Now question number 4. Write who went to the fair with Shyam. Now remember kids, who all are meet Shyam on the way when he visit the fair? Think about it. Yes, you are very right. Madhu, Meera, the dog, the peacock and the frog went to the fair with Shyam. Question number 5. Why did the horse run helter-skelter? Yes. The horse ran helter-skelter because he was frightened. When frog fall on the horse, he become very frightened, no? And that's why he ran helter-skelter. Question number 6. Classify the following animals as a domestic animals and a wild animals. Now tell me, what is the difference between domestic animal and wild animals? Yes. The animals which we can keep with us in our home, that called as a domestic animals or pet animals. And the animals which we cannot put in the house, they lived in jungles, so we call them as a wild animal. Here are some examples, and now we are going to segregate this in the two parts. Animals are dog, horse, lion, elephant, cow, frog, peacock and cat. Now tell me, which animal can be kept in the home with us and that we call as a domestic animals? Yes, dog, horse, cow and cat are domestic animals. And now tell me, from this, which are all are wild animals? Yes, lion, elephant, frog and peacock. We cannot put with us, no, in home. So, these all are wild animals. Question number 7. Write the names of any 5 vehicles. Now tell me, what is meaning of vehicles? Yes, vehicle means a thing that we use to travel from one place to another. When you don't want to walk, what do you use to travel? Yes, it can be bus, car, van, truck or bicycle. Question number 8. Write the names of things you see in the fair. Now tell me, remember the things you saw when you visited the fair? Yes, it is a hut, trees, balloons, Ferris wheels. Unscramble the words. Now kids, we are going to unscramble these words, or we will frame a meaningful word. Now this rohseracat, it is a horse cart. Next one is, this one is peacock. Find this word from here. Yes, it is a field. Find the word from this scrambled word. Toy. And the last one, fair. I hope kids you understand the whole lesson. Thank you so much for watching. Please share and subscribe.